right in the center.
We've got a tray full of red, white, and blue peppermints to go into our oven. And then something magical happens. Now you're gonna see it start to get nice and flat and shiny. You can see the sides already are doing that. Once everything is flat, that's when it's time to take it out of the oven.
All right, I've decided to make a bowl design. So I'm gonna spray this with our cooking spray. And now it's time to get the mince out of the oven. Okay, so
it's starting to bubble. That means it's definitely time to take it out. You can see how everything just kind of melted down. Carefully slide that off, just like that.
Oh, wow. All right.
Now, here comes the tricky part. Take this dish, it's already been sprayed, and it goes directly on, just like that. Press it down, get rid of all those air bubbles, and now you use your fingers to press it up around the sides. Now, be careful, because it is hot right now. You don't want it to burn you. And now, once we get it on, the idea is to flip everything so that gravity will do the work for you and the sides will fall down around
it. Are you gonna do that?
I'm waiting to let it cool just a little bit because it's burning my hands right now.
Okay, wow, all right.
All right, so we were able to flip it. Kyle had to assist, so he wasn't able to hold the camera. But we were able to flip it, and I just did it that way so you could see the way it looks through the glass. You get an understanding of what we're doing. But now, I'm just using my gloved hands to press this down on the sides, and that's gonna form, as it cools, a nice bowl. Or would this be considered a dish? What would you call it? Is this a dish or a bowl?
It's a candy dish.
I think it's gonna be a candy dish.
All right, now what? Now you start peeling the paper off?
See, you can actually slide it around to adjust it to make sure that each side is the height that you want it to be. All right, it's starting to cool now, and now we can start to peel that parchment paper back. Look at that, how cool is that? And it is very important that you spray your glass dish so that this part doesn't stick to it. But as it cools, you can separate that parchment paper, and then in just a few moments, this will be cool and hardened enough that we can separate the glass. All right, now I'm going to slide the dish. Be careful, because it's still hot.
Don't drop it.
This makes me so nervous. All right, now the tricky part comes. Separating the glass. And because we gave it a nice spray with our pan spray, it was relatively easy to remove. Now the pan is still hot, so be careful. We've got 3 12-ounce bags of white chocolate chips. Into each of these bowls, we're gonna add 1/3 cup of sweetened condensed milk. Now you're gonna pop that in the microwave for about 1 minute, stopping at 30 seconds to stir. And that only took about 1 minute of microwaving to get a nice melted consistency. I'm gonna do a few drops, stir, and then just go from there and see if we need to add more. And it's gonna go right into our pan. Now I'm using a rather small dish. You could use an 8x8 on this. Ours is just a little bit more than that. What, 7x11, right? I believe this one was.
I think so, yeah.
Now you're gonna just place that in the fridge just for a little while. That's gonna allow it to harden. And now we're gonna go back to our other bowls and start melting them in the microwave next. Because we want this layer to be white. Now to the last layer, we're gonna add some red food coloring. And remember, you can always add more as you go. This is gonna be so fun. This is perfect for a season like we've got coming up, Memorial Day, or of course 4th of July. But you know what, y'all, let me know in the comments what other color combos would be good for this one. There's so many possibilities.
Maybe graduation colors.
Yeah, you could do the school colors for graduation. That's a really good idea. Now I've got some fun sprinkles. We're just gonna add these all over to the top of our fudge. I've also got some fun sugar crystals. These are also great as sprinkles as well. But my favorite part is going to happen when we cut this in half and you see all of those beautiful layers. Isn't that cool? Look at that. Our tray looks beautiful. And here is our fudge. We've got three layers. I can't wait to see how this is going to taste. But we have just now realized that in all of the excitement, I forgot to use plastic wrap. You're supposed to put plastic wrap or aluminum foil in this so that you can lift it out easily. So we're just gonna go with it and see what happens, and fingers crossed I can get the fudge out. All right, here we go. I'm gonna give it a cut with my nice new knives. Okay, it's coming out.
Are you sure?
It's coming out. I'm gonna get it out. I promise I am. You just give it a cut all the way through. I look like I'm gonna murder somebody right now. All right, so y'all definitely let me know in the comments, do you like seeing our struggles and our mistakes, or should I edit that out and just make sure that everything looks perfect? Because I could do some magic with editing, but I have an idea that y'all might actually get a kick out of seeing us be real and raw.
And this is just a reminder to put cellophane at the bottom.
Listen, making these videos is not easy. There's so much going on. People are always asking us how we come up with the ideas. Sometimes we find them online. This is one that I actually found online, but this is one that I decided myself to make. I'd had the idea after doing this at Christmas with regular peppermints. How cool would it be to do it in the patriotic theme as well? But we are real, and we are doing a lot of these things for the first time, and I hope that you are entertained by it, because that is the goal. I think we're going to get it out. Do y'all have faith in me?
All right, here we go. The moment of truth.
Is it coming? Is it coming?
I think so. I can see it. Okay. Come on.
We might need a new spatula after this.
Keep bending it.
I'm getting some muscles. Y'all, I promise, I'm not stupid, and I'm not crazy. There's just a lot going on whenever we're making these videos. We often film like 5 or 6 of them a day, just so that we can have lots of new videos for you every day. Okay.
We've made this mistake more than once.
I know, this is not the first time that we forgot the parchment paper. If you've been a long time follower, you already know I've done that once before. Hey, it's coming, it's coming.
Once you get this first piece out,
It's coming, y'all. I hope that you're clapping for me at home when I finally get this thing out.
Yes, send us some hearts or some thumbs ups right now.
Okay.
You got it, yes.
It worked, we got it out, and now all I have to do is just cut this into individual slices like this. Well, we did it, y'all. I was a little worried there for a minute, but we ended up getting the fudge out, despite the fact that I forgot the parchment paper. But I think that we have a beautiful patriotic display now with our candy dish as well as our fudge. And what's great is that this is two ingredients. Two ingredient fudge, how simple is that? You just need 2 cups of white chocolate chips to 2/3 of a cup of sweetened condensed milk melted down, and that will give you this. Now, we use the red and the blue because this is a nice time of year to be able to celebrate something with patriotic themes, but you could use any colors you want. This could be for any holiday. As Kyle said, for graduation, this is a really fun thing that you can customize. Are you gonna come taste it with me?
I'm coming in, we're gonna do it.
Here you go, let me find you. Here's one, here's a piece.
All right, here we go.
All right. Let's do it. It's going to be sweet, isn't it?
I'm sure. Mmm. It's good, though.
Oh, man. It's really good.
Who doesn't love sweets?
I mean, it tastes like melted white chocolate. It's surprisingly not too sweet.
Yeah, it does.
I thought it would be too sweet, but it's not. It's nice. Y'all are going to love this one.
Mm-hmm.
What do you rate this one?